学历，也不可学问。
In your view, would you say that the woman flashing that image, she wasn't fully realized bodhisattva, or was she transcending religion, which is actually completely man-made? All religions are an art form and a fabrication of the mind anyway, especially man-made, really man-made religion. So do you think that Dakini Nipuma, who was a fleshly Dakini, and most Dakini were transcending the dualistic concept of right and wrong and all religion?
Yes.
Or was she a bodhisattva considered Buddhist?
Actually, yeah, she was a Buddha. She was a Nipuma, is one of the principal teachers of the founder of Shakyamuni. You know? When that the founder of Shakyamuni, when he went to India, he was looking a teacher. He said, I don't want many teachers. I want someone who can communicate with the Vajradhara. So he got the information. Nipuma is the one who can communicate with the Vajradhara. That means she's Buddha. So he attended her and received teaching. Yes. So it's Buddha's teaching, it's not Buddha's name. Buddha's teaching is explanation of the reality of nature.
这位师姐有问一个问题，就是在卡玛卡在卡祖的创始者就是一位叫做尼姑玛。这个尼姑玛他问的问题是他是不是一个空行母，是一个菩萨，或者是佛？尼姑就讲说他就是本来就是这个佛，然后。从有一段故事，那个时候他去印度呢去找师父的时候，他就是说要找一个人呢，真下大厅总共那就满了
你不满香港안하고딜투스왜국민권때는유추의통화권주민과그렇게몇시간과같은
就是香巴噶举派的一个香巴噶举派，它是属于相对于塔波噶举另外一个噶举派，叫做香巴噶举。它的创建者呢，叫做一个藏族，叫做呢琼波涅鸠巴。琼波涅鸠巴呢，他到印度去的时候，然后他就是他说我要拜的一个上师只有一个条件，就是我那个上师能够直接跟金刚石沟通，能够直接接受，就是与金刚石呢就是能够沟通，能够见到金刚石，能够接受金刚石法要的这样的一个上师，他才要拜他为上师。那在那个时候呢，他就遇到了两个有这样的一个能够直接亲见金刚石的这个上师。一个呢就是尼姑玛，就是尼姑玛这个女性，还有一个呢叫做苏嘎西蒂，也是一个上师。所以呢，他在印度呢只有一直这两位，一个是尼姑玛跟苏嘎西蒂。然后回去之后呢，他传的这个法脉呢就叫做香巴噶举，因为他所在的地方呢是香巴。那所以从这一点来说，从尼姑玛能够直接亲见这个金刚石，代表呢他的心性与金刚石没有任何差别。所以在这个问题上说，尼姑玛到底属于菩萨还是空行母还是属于佛的时候呢，能不能先说他能够亲见金刚石，他的心性与金刚石没差别，他呢其实就是佛。
Yes,
yeah,
对 first of all, you see, it's good to have this kind of discussions. another. You translate. Get the
sufficient. 如不解释说，好像这样子的教育是有一个问题 ，question and answer， 就是说，有人问他这样回答，会不会是比较好的问答？
Not just questions on that. What I was talking about. You said about the Vajrayana application of Vajrayana and general Buddhist teaching.
吴军问一下，刚才他介绍那个密续以这种这样的方式来介绍讲道，到现在是不是大家听了都觉得很受益呢 ？Yes.
I think yeah, it's a very important, you know.
这个是非常重要的，他希望大家能够受益。
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Rinpoche, just now when you mentioned about the sexual, in the first part, you also mentioned about the four immeasurables, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so how does it link together? That means you actually develop four immeasurables for sexual.
That is a purport to the system of the Mahayana, to the support practice, as well as Vajrayana. Now when you come to the more specific Vajrayana, then it is the union of the appearance and emptiness. The Chakrasambhara, appearance, and Vajrayana, emptiness. First is your mental quality. Your mental quality of luminosity and emptiness. That manifests yourself in that form. So it's not you are getting something from outside, but within. So through that meditative state, inseparable of the luminosity of the mind and inseparable of the emptiness, maintaining that state, you experience the great bliss. You see, that is how great bliss means the joy which is sealed by the transition emptiness, you see. So that's what is the union is explained here. Yeah. No. Otherwise, it's like in general, it's like a problem, no? So it's the man and female, this union, you know, this, you know, there's some, there's a powerful gate with all the knives, you know, weapons and all this, you know? So that's why I see. A lot of Mayanas, they don't like that. It's an upset. It's not good. It's not good. I should be very calm, peaceful, you know. Oh, what is it about, you know? But that's what the interpretation is. Vajrayana is taught through the symbol. It's the interpretation of symbol. That's it. Just generally, basically, like the five is. Why do you think of Vajra, or of Vajra? Even every dog has an interpretation. So the male female of inseparable union is not engaged in the sexual union. Other is an interpretation of the inseparable nature of your mind. Your true mind or direct mind. Some people say, absolutely, no, but it's your mind. Your mind, which is the inseparable nature of the clarity and emptiness. That when you see directly that without any operation, then that is that nature. So it's the expression of that nature.
Yeah, because I heard you mentioned about the four immeasurables like loving kindness, compassion.
Yes, that's the solution. That's for sutra system of the Mahayana and Vajrayana. So, where is this, like, say, engage with the sexual female? So, that was that's the whole drama of loving kindness, compassion.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Yes, Pastor, finish this. Then your turn. Yeah. Reorganize your question.
刚才那个师兄有问到你包里面是有多少，
包里面就是有两个，因为你的问题刚有讲到说他谈到这个感觉的时候有讲到这个四五辆地方包里面，就是说我再问他结合看他们的那个 link 在哪里。
就是这个师兄问，就是说刚才有讲到四无量心，而讲到这个关于药用，就是说刚才讲到这个麻米这方面那个教合在那个密续里面的这正义，它的关系是怎么样子。这样四无量心呢，在大乘里面在金刚乘里面的意义都是一样的。如果我们讲到就是那个在那个本尊的修持里面有所谓的出现的一种一个佛父佛母的拥抱很多不明白的人就以为就好像世俗方面的两个在交媾这样子的，认为说这个是很不如法的。其实呢它深深的含义呢，就是说抽的是色，就是空，空就是色，所代表的甚至金刚拥抱着佛母那个金刚亥母的甚至金刚呢，所代表的就是明空无我里面的明，就是说从心性里面显现出来明那方面的表现出来的是那个甚至金刚，也就是内心里面一个显现不了在那个真实的事项里面。然后所拥抱的佛母呢，所代表的就是内心在那个清净心里面的本质是空的，代表着是一个空性。所以这两个拥抱起来，就是我们时常讲的，在一个清净的境界里面，它是明空不二，就是真正达到了那个佛的境界里面，就是已经超越了言语，不是好像人所讲的哦这样子的，就是很肮脏啊。男女这样交媾的，只是他们本来的头脑肮脏啊，他就觉得看到这样子的佛像的时候，他以为佛去做这种样的事情，其实并不是这样子的。在密续里面，仁波切有讲到，很多时候是很多表象出来来去代表佛法里面的很深的含义就好像坐在那个莲花上，或者在一个金刚座里面，或者有那个血淋淋的人头在他身上，或者那个愤怒像，这些全部是代表着佛法一些很深的意义在里面。然后当我们观修这个本尊，观修说自己变化成一个本尊，就是一尊佛，就是甚至金刚有抱着佛母呢，其实都是你的心在作怪，你的心已经观到出来一个是佛父，一个是佛母。如果你了解这一点的话呢，你在那个修持方啊，你是追求恢复原本的面貌，就是找回你本来有的那个佛性，本来有的清净心，本来有的思想。很多时候我们说内心的显现出来了，看到的一切全部都是幻觉里面，所以你本身起那个分别心，分别心说是男女在交媾，其实是你的心在作怪，并不是外面有一个这样子的现象，这一点要非常的清楚。然后以这种禅修呢，在那个这种修持甚至金刚里面有那个观想到佛父佛母那种现象，如果明白这种更深的道理，明白的其实这个修行是要使我们呢更进一步呢清净我们的心，使得我们恢复和明白，不是一个普通人的心，恢复明白我们本来有的真如实相的话。然后所谓的真如实相呢，这边呢就是上师们很慈悲的，从经验里面的就只有一个明的那种境界，有一个空的那种境界，这种是要在当时你从你的经验来能够去觉受到，从文字上来去明白是没有用的。 然后这个明空这方面呢，一了解的话，其实呢，到最后呢，有这种觉受之后呢，到最后你会有一个了悟了这个明空的境界的时候呢，在修持中你会达到一种境界，就是 bliss， 就是大乐的境界，就是很快乐的。这种是很清净的，并不等于是凡夫所讲的男女交媾那种暂时的一种快乐吧，那种是相当的下等一下的。如果是以佛教的那个层次来讲，这种是非常清净的。因为这种大乐呢，就代表说真正的了悟的真正的所谓的空性，空性并不等于是说什么都没有。然后如果不了解这种，一看这个我们就好像吴姐讲，你的历史好像在看黄色的故事，黄色的大一样，以为这个就是一个 photography， 其实并不是这样，这个是原原本本的吴姐讲的，并不是我讲的。然后并不代表那个，并不是是这个。然后就是刚才有讲过，就是很多时候我们如果要消灭嗔啊，我们要注意到很多表象，很多心恶，如果他拿到那个月刀，或者是头戴的那个那些六状元或者耳环，这些全部都是代表着可能是一个四树地和四树地，或者六度波罗蜜，或者圆满的活佛，这种种这方面，我们一定要明白，并不是可以以一种普通人的见解来去看这个，不然那个修持简直是没有意义。所以这种这样子的表象，在那个佛父佛母拥抱着其实是要破除我们原有一种凡夫的分别心所代表呢，就是说在我们本有的清净心里面，明空呢其实是没有那个分别，我们所看到的一些网面的显现，其实呢到最终也就是一个清净心的显现，并不等于是说有这种东西，外境所看到的也并不是外境有这个东西。所以就是就是用语言来表达，就是inseparability of the illuminicity and emptiness， 就是明空不二的意思。刚才就是这个师兄问的解答就是这一点哦。
Yes.
Okay. Yesterday there was a question about samsara and bodhicitta.
Samsara and bodhicitta.
Ah, yesterday. So today, if a practitioner, because of bodhicitta, experience a hell state.
Experience
a hell state, a state of hell. But
hell.
A hell. Yes. Oh. But because of bodhicitta, maybe some realization about vinyasa, can the practitioner also realize that the hell state is just a dream?
Hell state is just
that
dream.
That means the hell state,
dream.
Dream state.
Okay. The
hell is equal to dream.
Dream, okay.
And my important question is, must this practitioner be a tantric practitioner, or can he like what we put in about past 2 days, right? We follow your 5 paragraph. That seems like a sutra kind of good, but also look a bit like tantra, so I'm a bit confused.
You said pastor, like hell is like a dream, or dream in hell. Still in the dream. In the dream, if you are in the hell, you will have the experience of something. Suppose if you're born in the fire, in the dream, you will feel the agony, the pain, isn't it? Would you?
Because you are so...
No, I'm saying in a dream.
Yeah.
You are dreaming, burning in the fire.
Yeah.
Would you feel the pain?
You'll be very hot.
You see?
Okay.
So still, so whether in the dream or real, in the real, say, we can't dare to dare life, if you're born in the fire, you will feel the pain. And if you're born in the dream, you will feel the pain.
But my second idea, second idea is that there's no beginning and end of hell, so the hell cannot be real. I wake up.
That's right. This also, when you realize this nature of samsara is nirvana, no more samsara. Make sense?
Okay.
That's what we are trying to prove with this analogy. Try to understand, I should say. Try to understand through this analogy, samsara is like a dream. Better get up out of this. When you're in the dream, if you're in the hell realm, get out, just wake up. No more dream. Like here in the samsara, you're dreaming, so get out of this. Better practice this.
My question is, can I do this as a sutra practitioner?
Yes, sutra you can practice. Yes.
So why need the
Chakrabhava
Tantra?
If there's some interest in it. If you're not interested, that doesn't mean others are not interested in it.
这位师兄有问，就是说，昨天仁波切有讲到，就是上沙拉，就是萨婆的，关于那个萨婆世界的苦和讲到菩提心，然后那个问题是说，如果有那个菩提心，有一个人他有很大的菩提心，然后他真的是，感受到去到地狱那种情形，也因为他有大的菩提心呢，而且明白空性之后，在那个地狱里面这样，是否是，他变成了不会有所谓的那个痛苦。就是说，因为他了解了空性，他所经验到这个在那个地狱那种情形呢，其实这个也是一个幻化，是好像他会了解到这个只是好像一个梦这样，这样如果就有讲到是说，不管你是在梦境或者在日常的生活里面，如果你在真的还是你不在做梦的时候，在日常生活里面，如果有一个火烧你，你还是会感到是痛苦。如果在梦中之中是看到是在地狱有地狱的火的时候，你还是感到是会痛苦的。最主要的原因就是把这样子的分别心嘛，转换过来，就是明白到如涅无二。如果明白到是如涅无二的时候，就会知道说没有所谓的轮回，也没有所谓的真正涅槃。这两个其实就是一个内心一个显现的。如果明白这一点的时候，这样你就会明白到，其实这个所谓的三波之苦也是一个内心的显现来的。所以在佛法里面很重要的时候，很重要的在修持呢，就是我们要了悟到他佛法的真谛，就是要明白要用我们的智慧去观照去明白。所以呢，在当今呢，现在我们在这个娑婆世界，我们也了解到其实这一切呢都是如梦幻泡影，就好像一个我们在做梦这样，然后就要深入的去体验内心，去找寻回和明白这个道理然后最主要是，既然我们还是生活在一种梦境、一种幻境之中呢，最好就是修持佛法呢，赶快醒过来，然后 处理这个三婆，不要再轮回啊、受苦，然后从这些思维啊、经典的一些佛陀的教育思维，其实都是可以啊、慢慢的去了悟的。然后这位师兄问了，如果是这样的话，还需要啊、修这个圣人经来做什么？如果这答案是说，就算你不喜欢修，还有其他人有兴趣修。
啊，我就是 again， 就完了，就 overtime， you know， I don't know why， you know， just keep。We should have break, isn't it? Yes, yes.
Why a lot of sentient being or human being scared to die? When you hear the word die, you hear
die. Yeah.
Cover the subject of
die. Yes.
Why? What's the reason? Is there a path away when you are happy when you want to die?
Yes, yes. It's everybody, whether because we're attached to this body.Attached to his life. There are some individuals who are happy to die, suicidal. You know? They think if you suicide, then suffering is finished. So they're happy to die. But most of us, no, we don't want to die. If you hear the death, so no, please, you know. Those who are attached to this life.So that's why, as you see, we begin our life with suffering, with the form. We die with suffering. See? For this truth, without Dharma understanding and practice, there's no other alternative method. You see?It's not the same. So, Dharma becomes indispensable to understand this whole phenomenon as an illusion. See, when you realize everything as an illusion, which is natural illusion, but we're not realized, we're not We have not opened it. We haven't revealed that. When you reveal the death for everything as an illusion, then death is part of that. It's just a transition. Then we may not have such kind of suffering. So there's a great practitioner who are highly accomplished.They die joyfully they die, happily they die. Because when you discover your mind totally, then you are going back to your home, so there's no suffering. Until then, it says we have this kind of duality, you know, suffering here.
You
have not mentioned about if there are people like to die because they want to commit suicide. Yes.
Then what is the consequence of committing suicide?
See, the suffering is unbearable. They cannot bear the suffering. It's also due to lack of the understanding of Dharma or due to lack of this understanding of the samsara. If you know the whole nature of the samsara,No, everyone is in that, state of suffering. Some are heavier than others. Then see, in our study of Dharma and understanding of the nature of this suffering, you start developing loving compassion. There are so many individuals who are suffering so much and they make suffering for themselves. It's due to the mental delusion. not from outside. Sometimes we blame to somebody else. I'm suffering so much because of you. I'm going all this through because of you. But that outside that can be a condition, an actual cause we have created by ourselves. Now, to recognize that, we need the light of the Dharma. Through the light of the Dharma, it can open the wisdom eye to see ourselves. Then, oh, yes, Dharma is as mission. It's not just a religion. It's not just created by Buddha. Rather, it's a method for the solution of our confusion, for the solution of the suffering, nothing else. That's what we as mentioned, we take refuge in Buddha, Dharma, Sangha. Not because of Buddhist, but because of desire to free from suffering, but because of desire to achieve peace and happiness, you see. So that's when you know this well enough, see the, the complete nature of the samsara, then you can really appreciate Buddha's wisdom. How great wisdom that Buddha has, and how great compassion that Buddha has. And taught all this directly, you know, in so many ways, as we're discussing, you know, the six interpretations, all like this, so many ways Buddha taught. To solve all the puzzle of the mind.
这位师兄是问关于生老病死里面死的一个问题，然后我这个解答就是说，每一个人出生了之后呢，其实都是对本身自己的身体的，对自己的生命是相当珍惜的。然后，但是是有一些意外的，就是好像我们看到有一些人会，很轻视自己的生命，就是无端端的去自杀，或者是最近看到很多人本身的藏着很多那个炸弹，就是趋向于使那个炸弹爆炸，然后自杀，然后也伤害到很多人。很多时候他们以为这样子死了之后呢，在娑婆世界所受的苦呢就完全没有了，所以他们有这样子错误的观念，是就是觉得去死他们是很高高兴兴的去死去做。一般来讲呢，我们是出生在娑婆世界，我们都不会说要即刻去死的，我们会执着于这个生命里面娑婆世界的一切的这是短暂的快乐。但是我们必须了解的时候，我们一出生在那边，我们一定会面对到那个痛苦，除非你不生。你出生的时候呢，因为业力所感染的，好像十二因缘所讲的，就是到最终呢，你是要承受业力里面所有那种果报，就是那个痛苦。有生命到最后，你最后也是要遇到这个痛苦。这样怎么样去解决它呢？就唯有修持佛法，没有其他方法，就是知道了佛法，怎么应用它来修持，使到我们能够得到快乐。然后这点呢，我就有强调是，也就是因为这样呢， 学习佛法呢是必须要有的，是非常重要的。所谓在娑婆世界的一切的显现呢，我们所看到现在我们一直以为是真的，如果深入去修行然后内修的话，我们会发现这些全部都只是一个幻化的，就是内心上的一些显现，只是因为无始以来的业力和我们的习气呢，我们不容易在这一生即刻就认定说这个是幻化，我们不可能有这种这样的悟了悟，除非呢得到三宝这方面的加持，然后从佛法里面的文思修才能够慢慢醒觉过来，才能够慢慢看到它的事项。从修持里面，如果我们能够大彻大悟的话，我们就不可能会再沉住于这种这样子的大痛苦。就像说那些大修行人，很多大彻大悟的大师们或者是大瑜伽师，他们已经了悟了生死的境界，了悟了那个空性智慧之后呢，当死亡来临的时候，他是很乐意快乐的接受这个死亡。为什么呢？因为他已经是找回他本有的清净心，他那个死呢不会像我们平常人呢会怕死，他是好像高高兴兴的回家这样，他再没有那个痛苦。除非我们达到那个境界，好像 这些大彻大悟的修行人呢我们还是有这种分别心，还会怕死。然后刚才那个师兄有问到是那些人自杀，他的最后的那个果报又是怎么样？仁波切是讲说，那个人自杀呢，他一定是不能够忍受到那种痛苦，而且自杀并不等于是说那个痛苦就能解决，其实他们本身呢就是对佛法没有认识，也没有这个机会，那个善缘能够接触到佛法，所以呢他也明白，也太不明白娑婆世界的苦。其实我们就讲说，每一个人在娑婆世界里面都是会面对痛苦，只是面对痛苦的那个层次不一样。有些人是生活里面是非常非常的艰苦，就在那个地方呢，就苦得不得了，好像在逼。有些人呢，那个苦呢，只是一点点。所以呢，如果我们修持佛法，我们就讲，我们就能够从佛法来明白到这一切轮回是苦，这种种的，最后呢，我们就会升起菩提心，对众生我们也会升起菩提心。很多时候呢，众生因为无明往念的关系呢，造业使到那个痛苦呢，就是到最后那个痛苦还是他们自己要承受。当他们面对痛苦的时候，他们还是愚痴，不了解那个痛苦很多时候呢是自己往昔来造的业，所以他要面对果报来的时候，他要面对那个痛苦。他们不明白这点的时候，他们还会觉得是那个人弄到我这样，不然我就不会这个痛苦。其实那个真相是自己内心的显现，很多时候呢是自作自受，那个苦来是因为自己做错的关系。也是说，那个真正的苦的原因呢，是因为自己的业力的关系，并不是人家那个外境使到你苦这么简单。如果能够明白了这一点呢，知道佛陀的教法是这么的深奥，这么的可贵的话，可以看到事情的真相的话，我们就应该好好的修持。因为就在讲说，佛陀把这个法讲出来，并不是只是说这个是一个宗教，或者是他认为是这样，他自己这样讲。其实这个是一个宇宙里面的一个真理。然后呢，所讲的佛法呢，是一个方便的方法，使我们能够对治我们所有的问题，解决我们本有的颠倒思想，解决使我们呢能够离苦得乐。也就是因为这样，好像过去讲到的，我们就要归佛、归法、归真。 所以呢，再一点强调就是说，每一个人都想离苦得乐，都想能够从娑婆世界这种样痛苦的境界，跳出去，然后从佛法里面呢，师父就在强调，就是我们可以看一个全面的看到，在娑婆世界里种种的现象，做什么到最后呢？如果是深知的自己静静的去思维的话，就会看到娑婆世界这种轮回的这种幻化，其实并不是一个好地方的，并不是一个我们应该是自作说要去追求的。这一切所谓的罢工，这一切所谓的这个暂时的快乐，并不能真正到最后帮到我们。如果明白一个娑婆的这种现象，明白苦气灭道，佛陀所讲的是真谛的话，我们就真正的会感恩佛陀，感恩佛陀的大悲心，感恩佛陀的智慧，因为他把那个教法真正的是毫无所谓的保守下来，就是原原本本很直接的就把这些东西很善巧的讲出来，希望我们能够接受这个教育，然后去学习，然后能够把我们的心嘛，找回我们的清净心。
Thank you. Yes, go ahead.
哦，동해탐재기종화간의종화래어니뭐소니보간제시거래디메바소야리탑시가래여래
동해탐재출발했어출발띠출발뒤띠머리빠달긴곳달긴곳에도와지쳐탐재화와다는애는예수주그래가시는방법이있어넘버2바지금동해도샤스도와오다캐리다주변교육알았으면머리받침으로도와오다캐리저다니고라주변맨어소주변맨어소하라머리받받재주맨어소
痛苦的原因呢是迷乱，这个迷乱也可以说是一种就是乱七八糟的一个现象，就叫迷乱，就是痛。我们之所以会痛苦，就是因为现在这个情况是乱七八糟的迷乱。那这个迷乱为什么会出现？就是因为我们无明的缘故，我们有无明这个原因。所以最根本的原因就是痛苦的原因呢，是最根本的话呢是无明。因为无明而产生的这个迷乱，然后迷乱的一个本性，这个性质呢就是受苦，迷乱的一个性质就是受苦。因此我们要去消除这个痛苦的话，我们要去让这个迷乱的这种迷相呢全部清干净。可是这个迷相不会自己清除的，你必须要将这个它的根，就是它的无明去除掉，才能够将这个迷相呢完全消除掉。所以呢，我们最主要就是要消除这个无明。这些道理就是在那个解脱宝藏园，那个冈波巴大师的解脱宝藏那里头提到的，就是说，所以说这个明相呢，就是我们的轮回，轮回的本性就是痛苦。那要消除这个轮回的方法，就是只有去除无明，它不会自己消失，只有我们要去自己去消除无明，我们要去努力消除无明，它这个轮回的迷乱才会消失掉。
So this question is, where do all this suffering come from and how do we supersede it or eliminate it? So the answer by Rinpoche is the root cause for, if the suffering actually comes from the confusions of the mind and it surfaces.All this confusion surface is because of our ignorance. So ignorance is a root cause of the sufferings. through ignorance, then we have a lot of confusion, done a lot of wrong deed, non-virtue, as a result that we suffer. So the way, the method to eliminate it, to eliminate the confusion actually is to get rid of the ignorance as stated in the Jewel Ornament of Liberations by Lord Kampo Pass. The phenomena of confusions in the samsara will lead to sufferings, and the method is to eliminate ignorance.
Good. Okay. So we have short break?
Yes.
Now they are coming in. Wow. Okay.